Well, you know, the 70s were the 70s. All kinds of things went on. Do we need to talk about sex and drugs? Well, I don't know if we need the lurid details. I was on an acid trip when I first picked up a camera and I started playing with it. I think the clicking was part of it, the little explosions that would happen every time I clicked, the dramatization of each moment, and also the cutting out little chunks of reality with the framing.
Give us a kiss, Willow. Willow, give us a kiss. Big one, big one, big. Yes, yes, yes. I like it, I like it, I like it. Yes.
Yeah, I remember the day with Lou and Nika. Lou was smoking like a fiend. He'd probably been up for 4 days. He didn't like to sleep a lot. And I do remember saying, I think I need to crash. And Lou looked at me and said, oh, Mick, don't be a big pussy. We're only just warming up. And Lou was only just warming up because he stayed up for another 3 nights. David, Iggy Pop and Lou Reed, at the time dubbed the Terrible Trio. They were subversive. And then there's a particular photograph of Lou Reed, Mick Jagger and David Bowie. This was the after party for the very last live performance that David ever did with Ziggy Stardust. This party was kind of special. I remember Jeff Beck was there. I remember Ringo was there. And then Mick Jagger showed up. He wanted to get a little slice of that glam pie. David was always a lot of fun. He was very playful. And he was always very open to me.
When you were a kid, did you come here for like they've always had the vegetable and fruit market?
Yeah.
You guys came here for that as well.
Yeah, so definitely.
I've always been a big fan and wanted to meet Mick and talk about potentially shooting for us. And we ended up talking a lot, not about shooting, about fashion and artists and people we knew and that type of thing.
And rock and roll.
And rock and roll, for sure. And then we saw each other at some parties or events around the city, and we ended up having dinner.
Do you know this image here at all?
I wouldn't got a clue. I wouldn't know where they were from, Adam. Nothing to do with me, Jack.
I would really consider Mick a very, very close friend.
This is a gentleman called Syd Barrett, who is the leader of an underground band called Pink Floyd. We had taken an acid trip together 2 or 3 weeks beforehand. I think that's when we talked about me going over, taking photos for the Madcap Laughs. It's Wetherby Mansions. And even though you can't see it from this, it's actually a pink Pontiac.
That was one of my favorite shots of Mick anyway. I loved the whole Syd Barrett sessions that he did. I thought Syd was such a intriguing human, intriguing artist, but I also thought that his style looked like something of a young artist today. It felt like it transcended time. And a lot of things that we talk about in terms of his pictures or other pictures that I like, they weren't followers. They kind of did their own thing.
Funny how those moments just live forever.